Very exciting news, because as of today, Softr is live with their new databases feature. This means that not only is Softr allowing you to build a robust business application in no code, but you can even store your data in Softr. This is giving you faster loading and much more responsive pages. So if you would like to learn more about the newest Softr feature, databases, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting. And it's my mission here to help you unlock the full potential of no-code tools. And in full transparency, that mission started off with Airtable, but it has evolved to much more. Because Airtable alone is not always sufficient to solve your business use cases, we have started plugging into other tools in the space. And one of those tools that we've been talking about for years is Softr. Softr allows you to build a front-end business application. So it could be the window to your Airtable data. But no longer do you require storing your data someplace else, because with this new feature, as I mentioned, Softr now allows you to store your data in their own databases themselves. And in this video, we're going to be walking through a brand new template. I'm going to show you where to find the data, where the databases live. And the best part is those databases are going to be created right from the template. So you can realistically launch your own Softr application, front end and back end, within moments. And you're going to see it all right here in this video. Now, before I get into the heart of things, I want to first invite you to follow along with me in your own Softr account. If you are new to Softr, you can use the coupon code that you see on your screen right now. We will include links at the bottom of this video, and that will give you 1 month free on the Softr Pro plan. But without further ado, let's go ahead and hop on into my screen here. I am looking at a template for vendor management. Now, as I mentioned, Softr has a bunch of different templates that they're launching out with this new feature. This is the one that we're going to take a look at. Imagine that you wanted to manage your vendors with your own no-code application. So we've got some functions like admin and user login, admin dashboard, vendor list, document management, self-serve vendor portal, and responsive design. We can open up a preview for any of our applications and kind of just poke around the various templates and see what it looks like. You can go ahead and sign in, apply now. You can see what it looks like in tablet or mobile. But for us, let's just jump back to the actual template itself and let's just go forward. Let's use the template. And you'll see that it just creates here in a few moments. Now, it's been true for a long time that Softr has their templates, and it was mostly the front end. And this is what you're looking at, right? This component right here, the main part of the screen, is what the front end of your application is going to look like when you deploy. Again, you can preview it in different modes, right? You can go into preview mode and you can see it in full screen or tablet or mobile. But the most important part here for our purposes today is to drill into the data layer. So this feature right here is brand new. And it also used to be that users were over here on the left-hand side. But in fact, with this new facelift, this new feature, I think that this layout makes a ton more sense, frankly, because we've got the interface, that's the front end. We've got the data, that's how people, or what is the information that people are interacting with. And then we've got the users up here. And this is really the third component of any application. But let's dive into data and see what it looks like. This is where we can plug in and say what we want to use inside of this particular application. And so we can go in and say, well, in this particular app, we have Softr databases. Let's see them. And this all copied over from the template, vendor management by software. And just like that, we've now synced up to our data source. In this case, our data source being Softr tables. And so we've got the four different components here. We have users. So our users are their own table within our data source. And we see that we've got email, name, telephone. You know, if you've been using no-code tools, I'm thinking Airtable, Smart Suite, Notion, you know, they all have a very similar feel in the way that the databases are interrelated. And so you can see that replicated here with Softr's tables. Now I've got the managed vendors here. So there are linked relationships. We can see that we're linking to a related record. Similarly, we have the role field here, which is a single select field, which gives us a couple of different options. They're either a manager or a contact. And of course, their the way that they interpret the application, the way that they experience the front end app is going to be different based on the type of user role they have. We also have avatars. These are files, actual images. Of course, this is sample data, but you get the idea. We can store files here inside of Softr databases. We have our telephone numbers. We have a name, as I said. This is text. This is a telephone field, an email field. So a lot of the different fields that you've probably grown accustomed to using with your different Softr builds already, those fields are now available right inside your Softr database. Here we have vendors. You can see that it's properly linked to our contacts. Again, we have contract PDF here. This is probably a sample PDF. It's going to take a moment to load, but you get the idea. All those fields that you have grown accustomed to using, here they are in Softr databases. Pretty exciting stuff. Now, the most exciting part, at least for me, with the databases, yes, it's very cool that I can have everything in one place, but the ability to have snappier, Softr applications. So let's be honest for a moment. Some of the feedback that I've gotten over the years from people using Softr, they've said, you know, it takes a little bit of time for my application to load. When I click on something, I want it to be snappy. I want it to load that application really quickly for my users. And the fact of the matter is, because Softr is querying your data set somewhere else, it's going to just take a little bit of time for that information to be queried, filtered, and presented nicely in your Softr app. So of course, yeah, there's a little bit of lag or delay in presenting that data in your application. But here's the thing, Softr tables, Softr databases, that's gone. There is no lag. There is no time to communicate with your data source. So let's actually test this out. I'm going to publish the app and we're going to go in and poke around and see what it's all about. I'm not actually going to be inviting anyone to use it. Now that I've published the app, I want to enable magic links so that I can go in and really easily impersonate somebody in the live environment of the app. So what we're going to do is move on over to users here. And on the authentication page, we are going to open up the magic link. So I've already toggled this on. You can do the same for your application if you want to allow people to get a unique magic link to easily log into the app. This is especially useful, as I said, for, you know, testing in the live environment. So now that I have that, I can go over to my users and you can see that I've created two magic links here for my magic users. I've got a contact here and then I have a manager. So let's impersonate this manager right here. We're going to copy this link and we'll open up in a new tab to view this person's, app. So this is Laura. You can see here, Laura can click up here, check out her account settings. And as she's moving through the app, you'll notice that things are loading a little bit more quickly than they were when we used to have to query Airtable or any other data set for that matter. When I load on that dashboard, boom, it's filling out really quickly. I can drill in here, update things. Let's move this to rejected, update the status. And you can see that the graph here was immediately refreshed to reflect the changes. The data is much more responsive, much faster to load here than it used to be. We can click over into vendors and just like that, you know, I'm recording at the same time, taking up additional bandwidth on my screen for my processor, and it's still loading pretty quickly. So I gotta say, I am excited about this new feature. Number one, it's just keeping everything in one place. So if you don't have to use a third-party place to store your data, why do it? This makes your subscription with Softr that much more valuable. And then the other bonus is snappier, more responsive load times on your applications. Very cool stuff. Now, another amazing feature within the new databases is that we can actually import information from a CSV. So if you are in here in your Softr database and you are going to add a new table, when you do this, notice that you have the option or the availability to import a table from a CSV file or comma separated value. Now, before we get into that, there are some other options, right? You can always just start with a blank table, no problem. Or you can soon generate with AI, import from Airtable, import from Google Sheets, and import from SQL. But for us, we're going to try out the currently available feature, importing from a CSV. And just this easily, we can then, if we have files with our data already living in spreadsheets somewhere, let's say, Then all we need to do is drop our file in here, and just like that, Softr is going to create that table for our data inside of our Softr database layer. And then we can go in and additionally link it up to the other components, make sure that all the data is interconnected and talking, but just that easily, dropping in a CSV and getting set up with a table. This is a big win, and it's pretty impressive that this is available with launch of this new feature. Now, a couple of caveats here. Workflows are not yet enabled. So if you're trying to pass data through any kind of automation in or out of Softr, it's not yet here, but it is coming soon. So stay tuned for more videos on this topic as this evolves, as the new feature becomes more and more robust and more capabilities are unlocked. I hope you got a ton of value from the video. Thanks as always for watching. And if you did get value here, give us a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel. It means a lot to us back here and helps us keep doing what we love doing. In the meantime, if there are questions that you have that did not get answered here, swing by our website. We've got a ton of resources to help you out. But most importantly, my friends, keep on building.